Greeting HMC friends, on this Ash Wednesday 2021. This special day that we begin the journey of Lent, as we start our journey towards the cross, the full implications of what crucifixion, and particularly the crucifixion of Jesus, means in our lives. And that journey ending in the glory of the resurrection. But as we start this journey, it is a solemn day. For we begin to go on that path that leads to the ultimate sacrifice of Jesus Christ giving his life for us. And so we pick up in the prophet of Joel, chapter 2, and reading from verse 12. Even now, declares the Lord, return to me with all your heart, with fasting and weeping and mourning. Rend your heart and not your garments. Return to the Lord your God, for God is gracious and compassionate, slow to anger and abounding in love. And God relents from sending calamity. Who knows? The Lord may turn and have pity and leave behind a blessing, grain offerings and drink offerings for the Lord your God. Blow the trumpet in Zion. Declare a holy fast. Call a sacred assembly. Gather the people and consecrate the assembly. Bring together the elders. Gather the children, those nursing at the breast. Let the bridegroom leave his room and the bride her chamber. Let the priests who minister before the Lord weep between the temple porch and the altar, and let them say, spare your people, O Lord. And this is the word of God for the people of God on this Ash Wednesday. And so thanks be to God. So today, we begin to look at maybe what we're going to give up, or maybe what we're going to do for this journey of Lent. But for Peter C. and for myself, there is something peculiar to us that we begin to think of. For as we go through our morning service and evening service today, we all have that very moving moment when we had the chance to make the sign of the cross on your forehead with the ashes that give today its name. But for Peter, C, and I, we know that means a black finger. As those ashes are mixed within some oil, and each time we dip our finger into that little pot, our fingers get blacker and blacker. And I can assure you that on the evening of Ash Wednesday, both of us try to scrub really well to get the stain off our finger. But I find that stain really beautiful. It is a black stain. And black, of course, is a sign of darkness, suffering. And it's a wonderful reminder that for each one of us, we are marked by the sign of the cross. So yes, if you're popping in to go and do your groceries after the service this morning, or maybe going to a restaurant this evening after the service, you may want to discreetly just wipe away that little cross. But for Peter C. and I, our fingers are really stained. And I love that because it reminds you and me of the cost of the sacrifice that Christ made for us. And so, yes, we will be stained today, and your foreheads could be stained today. However, we need to be reminded. And so I pray a blessing for you on this day as we begin our journey into Lent. Maybe this be a precious one as we draw near to Christ and we are reminded of how much God so loved us. So take care and God bless.